Grace, mercy, and peace be multiplied on each of you from the God and Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Listen, friends, I am so excited that you have chose to worship with us here at the Turkey Creek Church. We love you. We thank God for you. I do want to give a shout out to some of our members today who have done a tremendous job doing this Breast Cancer Awareness Month. I do want to start out by thanking all of our members for participating and our guests in worship in pink last Sunday. Today is Wigging Out Sunday. I want to thank all of those who dropped off wigs to the church this morning. Also, those who contributed financially so that we can be a blessing to the cancer centers here in our community. Also, those youth who participated in the Pink Pumpkin Contest and those who wanted to, we thank God for you. We're just excited about what you're doing to show your, amen, respect, observance of Cancer Awareness Month here this month of October. I also want to take time to highlight out that we also had a pink fashion show. I want to thank Reverend Sister Boone for a marvelous job for leading that. I want to thank Mother Baker and Sister Carolyn for leading our pink up the Turkey Creek campus. Thank you, ladies, for a tremendous job. And listen, friends, next Sunday will be Survivor Sunday. Please email us the names of those survivors and your family, if you're a survivor, and or your picture, so we can highlight you in our slideshow presentation for Survivor Sunday. We need those by this upcoming Wednesday. You can email those to turkeycreekb@gmail.com, turkeycreekb@gmail.com. Also, listen, so important. Monday is early voting begins here in our community and all over this land. There is early voting going on. So please, friends, make sure that you vote. Make sure that you encourage others to vote. Make sure that everyone that's your family, kindred, or acquaintance, make sure that they vote. So many people have died and sweat blood and tears and toil so that you can read and so that you can vote. So please, beloved, make sure you take advantage of that. Well, Jeff, thank you for allowing me that pastoral moment. What I want to do now, friends, is to breathe a word of prayer, read scripture text into your hearing, and then explain the word of our God and our Christ to you. Let us bow. Lord God, here we are today. We thank you for your sovereignty, your holiness, and your amazing grace. God, there's absolutely none like you. You are the vine, God, and I am the branch. God, apart from you, and we cannot bear any fruit. So, God, we pray, God, as your seed of your word goes forth, oh God, that you're the only one that can make it grow. God, word my mouth, my heart, oh God, my actions, oh God, may they only be the words and thoughts, oh God, that you usher forth, oh God. Speak to us, oh God. Speak a word, God, because we need a word, oh God, in times like these, oh God. Again, oh God, open the eyes of our understanding that we may behold the wonderful truths of your scripture. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us, melt us, mold us, use us, and fill us is our prayer. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. Listen, beloved, again, I'm so excited. Will you grab your copy of God's word? I'll be in the English Standard Version of the Bible there in that Davidic Psalm, Psalm number 37. Again, from the English Standard Version, Psalm number 37. I want to read several verses into your hearing. Fret not yourself because of evildoers. Be not envious of wrongdoers, for they will soon fade like the grass and wither like the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and befriend faithfulness. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in him, and he will act. He will bring forth your righteousness as light and your justice as noonday. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not yourself over the one who prospers in his way, over the man who carries out evil devices. Refrain from anger, forsake wrath. Fret not yourself. It leads only to evil. For the evildoer shall be cut off, but those who wait for the Lord shall inherit the land. In just a little while, the wicked will be no more. Though you look carefully at his place, he will not be there. But the meek shall inherit the land and delight themselves in abundant peace. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Listen, friends, will you permit me to use the time that is ours to share to talk to you from this theological thought and this homiletical headline? Fret not, but choose wisely. Let me play that for you again. Fret not, but choose wisely. Child of God, we are extremely fortunate here at the Turkey Creek Church, amen, to be multi-ethnic and multi-generational in our church membership. You see, our church membership here at the Turkey Creek Church includes, amen, both Democrat and Republican, does it not? In other words, as pastor, teacher of the Turkey Creek Church, I must not only exegete the text, but I also must exegete the people. Can I just be pastoral with you for a little while here? And I submit to you today, amen, that all the ethnicities, all the generations, all the political affiliations, amen, in the membership of the Turkey Creek Church that I serve have been hurting. They have been angry. They have been confused. They have been fed up. They have been lied to. They have been disgusted. They have been betrayed. They have been sick and tired of being sick and tired. And yes, they have even been fretted. Can I get a witness right here? And I don't know about all of our guests who are listening and watching with us today, amen, but the membership of the Turkey Creek Church have been struggling with that question that David was struggling with here in Psalm number 37. In other words, beloved, David addresses the question in Psalm 37 that has been plaguing God's people throughout all of the ages. Can I get and ask you that question today? I mean, just let me push it to you. Let me ask you that question that David asked in the text. Can I ask it to you? David wants to know in this text, why do the wicked seem to prosper while the righteous seem to suffer? I think that'll play that again, because so many of us have been wrestling with that in this day and time, in this mundane circumvention of life that we call life. We have been wrestling with this interrogative. Why does the wicked seem to prosper, amen, and the righteous seem to suffer? Child of God, it does not matter how God you are, how much scripture you quote, or how much Bible that you told, amen. Your chances are extremely excellent today, amen, that you have struggled with this question at some point in time in your life. Can I get a witness right here? Will you take my hand and notice the text with me and be my friend? Notice how during a time when people seem to be going from bad to worse, the psalmist David here urges us, the listeners and the readers of the text, amen, not to envy the wicked, amen, but to trust and obey the Lord our God. In the Lord all right today, amen. He tells us that we need to trust God, amen, because God will surely bring the sinners to an end, will he not? Amen. And also he will preserve the godly. Do you read that in your Bible? Does your Bible read like mine? Can I push it right here for a minute? Can I push it? In other words, friends, when the smoke of judgment clears, amen, the wicked will be no more. We won't be able to even know the place that they have been because of God's righteous judgment. But the godly, the text teaches us, amen, will remain and inherit God's promised blessing. So, child of God, amen, whatever you do during this time of pandemic, amen, and in this present political climate, do not get agitated, amen. Do not, amen, get heated, and don't you quit. You got to be like MC Hammer, regardless of what's going on in this time of pandemic and this political climate. You got to be like MC Hammer. You got to be too legit to quit. When you lay hands on your own self and say, self, you got to be too legit to quit. You see, if there ever was, amen, an exhortation for our modern world as we navigate pandemic and this present political climate. It is here in the text, the admonition and the exhortation to do not fret. Look at the person in the living room or at your computer with you, amen, or on your phone and say, do not fret. Can I tell you what we need to do instead of fretting? Beloved, you have to make a wise choice. Say, I must make a wise choice. And not only do you have to make a wise choice at the polls, you also got to make a personal wise choice. You see, you got to make a wise choice in your personal life, child of God. God has given us volition. And volition simply means that God has given you and he has given me and everyone the ability to choose. The Bible says, choose this day whom you will serve. Amen. And we must make a wise choice. Amen. And amen. And we know, amen, that we will know those who are disciples, those who, the Greek word, mathetes, we will know the disciples of God by the love they show. If you want to find somebody who's on their way where the devil is, all you got to do is look and find somebody who ain't loving nobody. Oh, shucks, I brought a witness just in case. The Bible says, by this shall all men know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another. Do I have any Bible readers here? So what do we do? Well, at the polls, this is what you do. You find the candidate which platforms a man appears to be loving God with all their heart, mind, soul, and strength. This is what you do at the polls. You find a candidate who appears to be loving their neighbor as their self. Let me pray, rewind right there. You got to find those who are loving the people of God in the Lord, all right. At the polls, you got to find out which candidate, amen, is willing to decrease so that God might increase. Are you with me right here? Amen. And the text teaches us, amen, that whatever someone does to the least, they have done it unto our God and our Christ. And not only must we choose wisely at the polls, child of God, but this text, amen, is imperative, amen, that we must also choose wisely in our personal lives. Repeat after me, I must choose wisely in my personal life. Can I push it right here? The first way we need to choose wisely in our personal life, amen, is we have to choose to control our walk. Let me push point number one again. We must choose wisely to control our walk. In other words, we must choose, child of God, day by day, moment by moment, second by second, and hour by hour to live a life that is pleasing to the Almighty God. Amen. Notice how the psalmist issues a twofold command to you and to me in verse number 3. The first command is to trust God. Repeat after me, I must trust God. You see, that is that we will walk by faith and not by sight, because his word will be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, will it not? And I submit to you, amen, today that God is still working out his eternal purposes in us, amen, and all things are working out for our good, regardless of who does them, what they say, and what is going on in our existential, amen, reality. The songwriter say, all things are working out for my good, and it's intentional, and the Lord is keep on blessing me. You see, I've discovered that we have to learn how to trust God when you can't even pull God up on your GPS. In other words, child of God, you got to learn how to, and I must continue to learn how to trust God even when we can't trace our God. You see, if my main man who's going on to be with the Lord, Dr. Matt King Carter, if he was standing here today, he would tell you that we got dog trials on every hand, and we can't right now in this present pandemic and this political climate, we can't understand all the ways that God will lead us to that precious promised land. I wish I had some old school folk watching and listening today. But he said that God will guide us with his eye, and we will serve him till we die, and we'll understand it better by and by. Hold your head up. Don't you fret. Don't you quit. Hang on in there. We'll understand. bulldog grip on this and a downhill pull. It doesn't matter what things look like. The just shall live by faith. Notice the second command that the psalmist gives us here in verse number 3. The psalmist tells us, amen, do good. Repeat after me, self, do good. Regardless of what's going on, regardless of how folks are cutting the food, regardless of how people are going from bad to worse, self, do good. Beloved, in other words, you and I, in this present political climate and during this pandemic, we are commanded to holy living. Let me play that for you again. Regardless of what's going on in our existential reality, we are commanded to holy living, are we not? And so is every candidate in this country. In other words, God expects all of his people to live a life that honors him and brings glory to his holy name. Beloved, God is pleased when we live for him. And if we want to learn how to really trust God, we have to make every effort to live for him, to walk where he wants us to walk, to talk the way he wants us to talk, to live the way he wants us to live, to give the way that he wants us to give. In other words, when we do his will, amen, his will take control of us and he will take care of us. All shucks in here. Regardless of this present pandemic and this present political climate that you and I are in, be not dismayed. Whatever betide, God will take care of you. In the midst of this pandemic and this present political climate, amen, he will take care of you. Whatever betide, amen, he will take care of you. You got to trust in God when you can't even trace in God. You got to hold on to God's unchanging hand. He will take care of you. Beneath his wings, a love abide. Is there anybody listening and watching that knows he will? Yes, he will. He will take care of you. Not only must we choose, amen, to control our daily walk, but the second thing, amen, that I see here in this pericope, amen, we must choose to condition our will. It's a choice. Walk around verse number 4 with me. Text says, delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Does your Bible read like mine? Notice the command here in verse number 4. Delight yourself in the Lord. This word delight means, amen, this over-exuberating, exquisite, amen, pleasure and delight in the Lord. Can I ask you a question? What do you focus on when a curveball comes across the home plate of your life? What do you focus on, amen, when life seems to knock the life out of you, amen? Amen. What do you, amen, focus on, amen, when problems show up, amen, and it seems like they're showing out? Do you focus on the problem or do you focus on your God? Child of God, I challenge you and also double dog dare you today to let your focus and your attention be on the Lord. Trust in him who will not leave you whatsoever years may bring. Oh, shucks in here. If by earthly friends forsaken, still more closely to him cling. You got to have your delight in the Lord and you got to hold to God's unchanging hand in the Lord all right today. Is there anybody here who don't mind just saying this with me? Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing, even in the times where it don't look like it, I am still blessed. Amen. I thank God that he's all over me and he's keeping me alive. I will delight myself in the Lord because this is the day that the Lord has made, and we ought to be rejoicing and be glad in it. I delight in the Lord because the battle is already won. The fight is fixed. Amen. And the end, I'll rise with Jesus. Is the Lord all right? Oh, shucks in here. There ain't born again believers who are listening and watching today who can testify that the Lord is all right. Excuse my grammatical regression. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? If you know the Lord's all right and you delight in the Lord, what, where you are, give God some praise. Beloved, we have to learn how to lose ourselves in the Lord. Amen. When the Lord is our delight, we will only want the things in our lives that bring him the glory and the honor. Child of God, not only must we, amen, choose, amen, our walk. Not only must we, amen, choose, amen, our will, amen, and condition our will. The next thing I see in the text, amen, we must choose to commit our way to God. Repeat after me. I must choose to commit my way to God. Will you take my hand and be my friend and walk around verses 5 and 6 with me? Text says, commit your way to the Lord and trust in him, and he will act. He will bring forth your righteousness as the light, amen, and your justice as the noonday. Child of God, this word commit means to roll on to. Let me play rewind. Here in the text, in this context, the word commit means to roll on to. And what David is suggesting to you and I, amen, that you and I need to roll our burdens onto the Lord. Isn't the Lord all right today? Who wouldn't serve a God that'll chase you down to save you, amen, and turn around your bless you, and then fool around and allow you to roll your burdens and your cares and your problems onto him? Isn't the Lord all right today? Beloved, the Lord has literally asked you and I, according to this text, to carry the burdens of our life and leave them with him and lay them on him. He tells us to bring them unto him. He says, cast your cares upon me, for I care for you. Come to me, all of you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest from your soul. You see, my grandmother, Selena Thomas, amen, and amen, she died in, amen, October 2000, amen, 17, amen. And she was here today. She would simply remind you and I, and she was helping me to preach this thing. She would say, baby, God will be your burden bearer. Amen. And she would say, he will also be your heavy load, Sheriff. Can I just stop by Hope Sound for a minute? Hope Sound, Florida, where my grandmother, amen, Miss Bessie, amen, Lewis would be sitting in the amen corner in the old church next door to her house, amen, where her husband was a former pastor there at the AME church, amen, and she would sit in the amen corner, and she would sing the song, take your burdens to the Lord. Oh, shucks, I wish I had somebody here from the old school. Take your burdens to the Lord and leave them there. Isn't the Lord all right today? In other words, amen, my grandmothers were simply saying, is that God is never harried by your worry. They are simply saying to us today, even though they're going on, but they're saying to us today, amen, he does not get excited when we struggle against the situations that you and I find ourselves in. Amen. And that is including this pandemic, amen, and this, amen, time of political climate, amen, because he's omnipotent. He's all powerful. He's omnipresent. He's everywhere at the same time. He just got off the subway, amen, in New York, amen, and off the airplane in L.A., California, and he just got through sipping some sweet lemonade on the beach of Miami, amen. And a matter of fact, he was walking through the Atlanta airport right now. He bumped into himself, and he had to say, excuse me, God, because he is omniscient. He knows everything. He knows what you're going through. So all you got to do, baby, regardless of what's going on in this time of pandemic, and yes, in this political climate, have a little talk with Jesus. Oh, shucks. Preach, boy, I'm doing the best I can, Lord. Tell him about your trouble. He'll hear your faintest cry, and he'll answer by and by. Can I get a witness right here? Amen. And when you feel, amen, that fire burning, you'll know that your prayer wheel is turning, and a talk with Jesus in times of pandemic and political climate like this will help you to vote wisely, and a talk with Jesus will make everything all right. Can I push it right here? Child of God, the text is teaching us that we do not have to bear our heavy burdens by ourselves. Now, that was a good place to shout right there. Can I tell you why? Because we have a God who cares for us, and he commands us right here in the text to bring our burdens unto him. In other words, when we are walking by faith and placing our burdens on the Lord, he will take care of us, but we must choose. There it is. We must choose wisely to allow him to be God and for us to be his people. Oh, let me play that for you again. We got to allow him to be our daddy and provide for us and take care of us and us be his people, because he promises us, amen, that our faith in him will never be in vain. I see something else here in the text. Will you walk around verse number 7 with me here? Notice what David says in verse number 7. He says to you and I today, be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not yourself over the one who prospers in his way, over the man who carries out evil devices. In other words, beloved, verse number 7 is telling you and I today, amen, that we must choose to consecrate our waiting on the Lord. Let me play that for you again. We must choose to consecrate our waiting on the Lord. Here in verse number 7, David tells you and I to be still in the Lord and wait on him, does he not? In other words, this translates to being silent in the Lord. You see, also we're told in this text, verse number 7, that we don't need to fret. Now this word fret translates to mean to blaze or to be hot. In other words, you and I are not to get ourselves so worked up that we wind up in a rage over the condition of this world, over any trial, tribulation, over any mountain we have to climb, or any valley that we have to go through. God is telling you and I today that during these difficult days, that we need to be patient with him and in him while he works out his purposes in your life and in my life. Are you with me right here? Can I just be extremely transparent right here? And just can I be real and just can I just push this thing? Child of God, being still in this pandemic and this present political climate is not easy, even for a preacher. Y'all not gonna pray with me. However, child of God, Jesus Christ himself modeled how to be patient and depend on God in the most dire of circumstances. You know, when he was mistreated and mocked and crucified on a hill called Calvary, the Bible said in Isaiah, he was oppressed and he was afflicted. Yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb before the slaughter, and a sheep before the shearer is dumb, so not he opened not his mouth. Amen. I believe he just casted his vote with God and said, Daddy, this is what I need you to do. All I'm saying today, that regardless of the burden, amen, you and I are not called to complain. We're not called to make excuses. We're not called to act a fool. We're to make a godly choice. Amen. We're to depend on God. Amen. And we're to bear our burden for the glory of God and wait patiently on him, and he will work it out in our lives. Oh, shucks. It's breast cancer. It's breast cancer month, and I'm preaching my own self happy. I'm preaching my own crazy self. And so just let me hit it one time for the turkey creaking guest. Ooh, Lord. Well, beloved, that means I gotta close this little bit of sermon. But verse 8 says, amen, that we are to choose to refrain from anger. Does your Bible read like mine? Amen. Verse 8 says, yes, Lord, that we are to choose, amen, to forsake wrath. Amen. Verse 8 says, yes, Lord, that we are to choose not to fret. Amen. Because when you and I fret, amen, the Bible says in verse number 8, that it only, yes, it only leads to evil. Yes, we must be careful, amen, that we do not abandon righteousness. Amen, for evil, amen, in the day of our affliction. Yes, because all evildoers will be repaid. And I just got to ask you the question today. Amen, is there anybody, yes, Lord, who is listening and watching today, who knows that, amen, that we must never give up. Yes, we must never give out. Yes, we must give in our will into his will, amen, and our ways into his ways. Is there anybody who's listening and watching today, amen, who knows that God will see you through? Amen. Is there anybody here who's listening and watching today, amen, who knows that the Lord is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you can ask, do, or think? Yes, is there anybody here know that the Lord won't let nothing separate you from his love? Amen, neither height nor depth. Yes, no principalities, no angels. Amen, nor things present, nor things to come. Yes, our God is able. I said the Lord is able. Y'all know him, don't you? What a friend we have in Jesus. Yes, all of our sins and greed to bear. What a privilege to carry, amen, everything to God in prayer. Y'all know him, don't you? Have you trials and temptation? Yes, is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Y'all know him, don't you? He's heaven's best. He's earth's only hope. He's hell's greatest fear. He's a myth to many, amen, and he is a villain to some. Y'all know him, don't you? Born in Bethlehem, reared in Nazareth, ministered in Jerusalem, crucified on Calvary. Y'all know him, don't you? He died. Oh, shucks in here. He died. I said, didn't he die? He died. Amen. To heaven, amen, stood up on his feet. He died. And to hell got happy. He died. And to Job got the new, there's a new war horse Paula in the valley. He died. And to the centurion said, surely this must be the Son of God. One writer said it was soon. Another one said it was early. I don't know where it was soon or early, but he got up. He got up with all power, healing power, delivering power, power to walk right, power to talk right, power to choose right, all power in his trusted in his hand. Beloved, regardless of what your lot is, regardless of this pandemic, regardless of this political climate, trust not the Lord by feeble sense, but trust him for his grace. Behind a frowning providence, he hides his smiling face. His purpose ripens fast, unfolding every hour. The bud of life may have a bitter taste, but sweet shall be the flower. He suffered, bled, and died, and rose for you. Will you make the wise choices today to accept him as your Lord and Savior? And if you have been fretting and you have not really been living for him, if you've been anger and burning hot and it has caused you to sin, will you repent of your sins? Will you get yourself and your family to the post? And will you look for somebody that's loving God with all their heart, mind, soul, and strength, and loving their neighbor as their self? Will you make the wise choice? Will you make Jesus your choice today? He's standing at the door knocking. Amazing sight. Jesus stands knocking at your door. 10,000 blessings in his hands to satisfy the poor. Will you make Jesus your choice? If you're ready to make Jesus your choice, I want you to pray this prayer with me. Lord God, I'm a sinner. Please forgive me my sins. I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart that you are Lord to glory of God the Father. Thank you for dying for me. Thank you for rising for me. And thank you that one day you will come back again. I am saved. I'm truly saved. Amen. Listen, friends, if you prayed that prayer, welcome to God's Forever Family. Here's your next steps. I need you to scroll to the bottom of our website, www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org. Again, scroll to the bottom, fill out the contact us section. Or please call right now, 478-272-9169. 478-272-9169. Amen. And we want to help you with your next steps in following our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Listen, friends, there may be someone here today who has been hurting, who has been fretting, who has been burning hot, who has been experiencing the disadvantage of life, who's been struggling during this pandemic and this present political climate. Listen, if that's you today, will you go to God in prayer with me? Lord, I've been struggling. I've been straining on my journey home with you. Please forgive me of my sins. Prop me up on every lean aside. Give me peace that passes all understanding. Please make provisions in my life. Please provide protection in my life. And please grant me that peace that passes all understanding. And keep my heart in the knowledge and love of you. God, I thank you and I love you. Amen. Listen, if you prayed that prayer and you need someone to walk alongside you as you work out your own soul salvation with fear and trembling, listen, friends, we're here for you. I love to be your pastor. If someone would like to be a member of this church, again, log on to our website, www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org. Fill out the contact us section. Also, you may call 478-272-9169. Listen, I would love to be your pastor, amen, to serve you, to pray to God for you, amen, and to study and to teach and preach the word of God unto you. Amen. Again, thank you so much. We love everyone. Listen, next week is Survivor Sunday. Tell a friend, grab a friend. Let's tune in. And whatever you do, don't fret, but make the wise choice. Amen. We have seminars coming up this month. Ms. Shaquita Moore will be doing a breast cancer seminar on October 20th. And also, she will be doing a prostate cancer seminar on October the 27th. At this time, let us listen to Devonna for our announcement.
Greetings from the news desk at Turkey Creek Missionary Baptist Church, where Dr. Frederick C. Williams is the pastor. My name is Devonna Watson, and I am here to bring you this week's news from the Creek. Monday prayer line will be at 7 a.m. and 9 p.m. The toll-free number is 1-302-202-1110. The conference code is 777-581. And now for this week's prayer request.
This week's prayer request, we have Annie L. Lowry, Osnola Davis, Mother Christine Baker, Hattie Thomas, Murray Smith, Martha Farmer, Lucille Collins, Latrell Roach, Joyce Tyson William, all PK through 12 and college students, Vaughn London, Pat Rooks, Victoria Wright, Rosa Lee Simmons, McKinley Williams, Mary Mitchell, Brittany Paldo, Wilbert Roberts, Ella Lee Way, Mary Edmond, Stevie Ward, James Cartwright, Carla Cartwright, Deacon Richard Hunter, Reverend Isaac Lawson, Brother Wes Moore, Clifford Garnto, Lenny Tharp, the Pittman family, and the Hunter family.
And now for this week's birthdays.
This week's birthdays, we have Malia Tidwell, October 12th, and Leola Baker, October 16th.
Friends, it is giving time. There are three ways to give tithes and offerings to the Creek. The first, you may mail your gifts to 1164 Williewood Road, East Dublin, Georgia, 31027. Or you may use our Cash App. Our cash tag is the $TCMBC828. Again, our cash tag is the $TCMBC828. You may also give by logging on to our secure website, www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org, and click on the giving link. Then follow the easy instructions on the screen. Again, log on to our secure website, www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org, and click on the giving link. Then follow the easy instructions on the screen. Please remember, Paul told the Corinthians church in 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter, verses 6 through 7, in the English Standard Version. The point is this: whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each one of us must give as he has decided in his heart, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Thank you for sharing in your giving.
Here's a spiritual challenge for you. Will you commit to praying for the salvation of one lost person and seek opportunities to share the gospel with him or her? It can be a friend, relative, coworker, classmate, or acquaintance. It can even be an enemy. After all, Jesus did tell us to love our enemies and pray for those who persecute us in Matthew chapter 5, verse 44. Pray and invest in one person the Lord places on your heart that needs Christ. Make a commitment today. Identify your one. Begin praying daily for your one and seeking opportunities to tell them about Jesus and invite them to church. Will you commit? Who's your one? Just a reminder, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month and Clergy Appreciation Month. Please be sure to read the bulletin for Breast Cancer Awareness Month activities. Also, please be sure to give a shout out to our pastor and ministers at the Creek. Turkey Creek extends a hearty congratulations to Carolyn O'Neill on the birth of her granddaughter, Olivia Grace Orange. May the Lord continue to bless you and your family. This has been your weekly news from the Creek. My name is Devonna Watson, and I hope to see you all next Sunday. Have a blessed day.